All right, it's Patriot Week, and that means we're looking forward, not back. I know it's Tuesday. I know we all felt good about a great defensive win over Carolina. And sometimes you want to hang on to those wins for a little bit longer. But
carrying it right here, my friend.
Right. We'll leave it there, and we'll look ahead, because this is one of the more exciting weeks in a long time for Seahawks football. They're playing well. You got the Patriots coming in to test the defense and to test one of the basic tenets of the conversation that we've been having and we had with Danny O'Neill that you can listen to on the podcast today. And that is, can the Seahawks win, make the postseason with half a team?
I think it's going to be tough.
Two-thirds of a team, because special teams are pretty good.
Special teams, don't forget about those guys.
In other words, with an offense that's producing very few points, forgetting, we won't even go into specifics, we'll just talk about points. On offense producing very few points, can they take on, because their defense is good enough, the elite teams? So I guess maybe the question is, we know that they can. How long can they?
We're going to find out. Their next two games are going to be as tough as it gets through the entire season. You've got the Patriots at home this weekend, followed by the 49ers on the road, who are piling up points, and they've got the best defense in the league as far as points allowed. I think you're asking a lot of a defense, and Danny O'Neill, we spoke to him, you can check it out on the podcast, wrote a piece about it, like how long can you basically expect the defense to cover up all the flaws or the shortcomings of an offense? And I think, you know, we've talked about this a lot, that at some point the offense is going to have their back a little more than they do, because right now they don't. The defense is really, really carrying the load, and they're capable, and I think it's a fair expectation that they're brilliant every week, but they're not going to shut everybody out. They're not going to continue game after game after game keeping the opposition out of the end zone like they have the past two games. I just don't think it's a fair expectation. Doesn't mean it's not possible, but at some point you'd like them to have some slack. Mm-hmm. You want the offense to just be decent. Take advantage of opportunities. They don't have to be electric. They don't have to be the greatest show on turf or Peyton Manning with the Colts. But give a little more than they've given. And even Pete Carroll said, hey, just one more touchdown a game is such a difference maker, you're talking about.
Well, I agree with that at 1,000%. When you get one more, this team could get one more touchdown with that defense, it might be enough. But, you know, you got a rookie quarterback. We on the show today kind of looked back at Joe Flacco with the Ravens in particular, mm-hmm. his first year, even Ben Roethlisberger's first year with the Steelers, both those teams getting to their respective championship games that year, one year away from the Super Bowl. It was amazing. Flacco's numbers were like almost exactly like Tavares Jackson's from a year ago.
And a little higher quarterback rating.
A little bit better. And Roethlisberger really had a pretty good, you will have to concede, pretty efficient year in his first year. But those are teams led by defense that did not change their stripes during the year. And the one thing that's kind of tough.
And heavy running teams.
Stayed that way, too. And one of the things that's kind of tough for us is, I think we're building a defensive tradition here that looks like with these young guys is going to be in place for a long, long time. But it's just starting. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's hard to be a Ravens fan, as you were, to say, you know what? We figure every game, you know, we'll hold them to 14, and if we can figure out a way to get 17 points, we can win. But that's kind of how it's going to be all year. I mean, as much as I think maybe they'll take a chance or two here, and certainly you're going to have games like the Dallas game already, where you manage 27 points, where mm-hmm. you're going to score some points. But I got a feeling for Seahawks fans, most games are going to be like last week. I don't think it's going to matter that Carolina, New England, most everyone the Seahawks play are going to be in a dogfight. It's going to be low scoring. It's going to be tough. And, you know, the toughest team ultimately will win it. And it usually will come down to the last possession. And I kind of feeling like that's how it's going to be all year, buddy. So, Maalox.
Can we get just a little bit more?
Lots of it.
Just a little bit more.